And I just wanted to sort of wrap up by, again, thanking you for watching and tuning in on the World Wide Web. I am super flattered and I'm excited to get to hear from all of you and hopefully answer any questions you might have. I think that certainly there was a time in my life where this was all really new to me, but now that I've been introduced to this world and these artists, they are without a doubt my favorite contemporary art voices. And the practice is so intuitive and natural. And I love working with the population that I work with, both as a teacher in special education, and then also in the artistic context of SAGE. So I just kind of wanted to end by saying that if any of you are interested in pursuing this kind of work, I think that it's really worthwhile and, you know, takes very little accommodation. And the most sort of powerful tool I think we all have is just our ability to deal with our own discomfort. I know when I was growing up that special education was sort of sequestered to a portable outside, and there was very little interaction between neurotypical students and students with disabilities. And I think that still exists within our culture today. There's a lot of sort of, there's still a pervasive division. And one of our goals at SAGE is to help minimize that and to create a more egalitarian and inclusive climate where artists with and without disabilities are working alongside each other, are exhibiting alongside each other, and where these people are really seen for, first and foremost, for their incredible talents as artists and not identified first as people with disabilities. So let me know if you have any questions, if I can guide you to any resources. I love talking about this stuff. I wish that I could be there in person, but thank you so much for the opportunity. Bye.